Supreme Court has cracked the whip on the BCCI sacking the board president Anurag Thakur and secretary Ajay Shirke. The court also initiated contempt proceedings against Thakur. The verdict in the BCCI versus Lodha committee came after months of a bitter court battle. A committee of administrators will run the board now. Senior advocates Fali S. Nariman and Gopal Subramanian will assist the court in nominating members in the committee of administrators. The senior most BCCI vice president C.K. Khanna will act as president, while the joint secretary Amitabh Chaudhary will act as secretary. Well, some breaking details coming in right now. NewsX has accessed the Supreme Court order copy on BCCI. Yes, NewsX accessing that Supreme Court order copy on the BCCI. Rishabh Gulati, executive editor, can join us with further details. Rishabh, over to you.
Thanks a lot, Uday. I've got the order copy here. It's 25 pages which have been put out by the Supreme Court. Let me get straight to the operative part if I can. Here it is. And this is where the criticism of the BCCI and the reasoning for the order that was passed is explained in point number 13. The position as it has emerged before the court is that despite the fact that there is a judgment and final order dated the 18th of July accepting the report submitted by the committee, the implementation of the directions issued by the court has been obstructed and impeded by the order of this court on 7th October and the subsequent directions that were issued on the 21st of October. Sufficient time was granted to the BCCI to abide by the judgment and order of this court. Initially, as the committee informed this court, the BCCI appeared to have taken the position that it was only if its review petition as well as curative petition were dismissed that the recommendation of the committee would be accepted. This statement of the BCCI at a meeting of its working committee held on the 21st of October was manifestly misconceived. Once this court had affirmed the recommendations of the committee in a final judgment and order dated the 18th of July, the judgment had to be implemented as it stands. By the order of this court dated the 21st of October, this court made it clear if indeed such clarification was at all warranted. As a matter of record, both the review as well as curative petitions have also been dismissed. Yet, the intransigence of the BCCI has continued. The course of events indicates that though sufficient opportunities have been granted to the BCCI to comply with the judgment and order of this court, it has failed to do so. The President, the Secretary and the office bearers of the BCCI have obstructed the implementation of the final directions of this court on the basis of a specious plea that its state associations are not willing to abide by the directions. This court, having furnished sufficient opportunities to the BCCI to comply, it is constrained now to take recourse to coercive steps to ensure that the directions contained in its final judgment and order are not to be left to be a writ in sand. The committee consists of a former Chief Justice of India and two former judges of the Supreme Court. They have together been tasked with overseeing the implementation of the judgment of this court, yet the committee has repeatedly been confronted with a barrage of unfortunate comments by the BCCI in press conferences and in correspondence with an intent that it should be led to a situation where it throws up its arms in despair and frustrations. Among the recommendations of the committee that have been accepted by this court are the following disqualifications for being an office bearer of the BCCI and of state associations. And it lists them: that the person is not a citizen of India, 70 years of age and below, that age gap has been reintroduced, is declared to be insolvent, is a minister or government servant, holds an office or post in a sports or athletic association or federation apart from cricket, has been an office bearer of the BCCI for a cumulative period of 9 years. That's not 9 years in a stretch, but 9 years in toto, which has a manifest bearing on several of the BCCI board members. Has been charged by a court of law for having committed any criminal offence. Again, a manifest bearing on several of the BCCI board members. The committee, in its status report dated the 14th of November, drawn the attention of the court to the fact that the several office bearers, both of the BCCI and the state associations, continue to hold posts, although they have stand disqualified in the terms that have been already issued of service. It goes on to say that above the norms which have been accepted by this court, persons have a vested interest in continuing their positions in spite of the norms noted above, have ensured that the writ of the court is obstructed and impeded. We need to emphasize that the turf of the cricket field is not a personal turf of fiefdom. We must hence order and direct that no person shall hereafter continue to be or entitled for appointment as office bearer of the BCCI or a state association in breach of the above terms. All existing office bearers of the BCCI and of the state associations who do not fulfill the above norms shall with effect from the date of this order stand disqualified. This is going to mean, well, certainly a large percentage of the state association chiefs, state association members, and of course of the board of control themselves, including several of the senior members who have been part of the BCCI's committees for a very, very long time. Goes on to say in point number 19, that leads to the court to the issue of the conduct of Anurag Thakur, president of the BCCI. By the final judgment and order of this court, the plea that the appointment of a nominee of CAG would amount to governmental interference with the affairs of BCCI was specifically negative. It goes on to say, and I'm moving on quickly to page 13.20, once this position had been laid down by the court, there was no occasion for the president of the BCCI at the ICC governance review meeting held at Dubai on 6th and 7th of August 2016 to solicit a letter from the chairperson of ICC. Such a solicitation was but an effort to thwart the implementation of the orders of the court. Moving on to page number 15, point number 21. On Shashank Manohar, this says, the response by Mr. Shashank Manohar indicates that the president of the BCCI requested him on August 2016 to issue a letter in his capacity as ICC chairman in terms of the position that he had adopted as president of the BCCI. It goes on in point number 22 on page number 16. Prima facie, it would appear that minutes had not been seen in the light of the day when the response by Mr. Shetty to the report of the committee was filed and have been fabricated subsequently to lend credence to the version of Mr. Thakur. The statement that Mr. Manohar was requested to clarify the position which he had taken as BCCI president is falsified by Mr. Manohar's disclosure that he was asked to give a letter in his capacity as ICC chairperson. The version of Mr. Thakur that he had requested Mr. Manohar that he, being ICC chairman, can a letter be issued clarifying the position which he had taken as BCCI president is belied by the disclosure which has been made by Shashank Manohar. It goes on to say that Mr. Thakur did seek such a letter from ICC chairperson as stated by Mr. Manohar. This disclosure which Mr. Thakur has made in the affidavit is prima facie false to his knowledge. It goes on in point number 24 on page 17. In determining the modalities to be followed, we have drawn sustenance from the order dated the 28th of March 2014, passed by a bench of two learned judges of this court, A.K. Patnaik and F.M.I. Khalifullah. In view of the circumstances which had been arisen, resulting in the president of the BCCI being unable to perform his duties, this court appointed a distinguished cricket person as an interim measure to exercise the powers of the president in relation to IPL 2014. With regard to all other matters, the senior most vice president of the BCCI was under the orders of the court permitted to discharge the functions as the president of the BCCI. So clearly, in very, very unambiguous terms, the Supreme Court has said that at various attempts were made to thwart its directions, to thwart its orders, and it has now therefore explained the reason behind, the reasoning rather behind its move to actually replace the two senior most officials of the BCCI with nominees from the Supreme Court itself.
Absolutely. Well, thanks indeed for joining us with all those exclusive details, Rishabh. What we want to do now is we want to play out Anurag Thakur's reaction to these developments.
Namaskar. I had the honor of serving Indian cricket. Over the years, Indian cricket saw its very best in terms of administration and development of the game. BCCI is the best managed sports organization in the country with defined procedures. India has the best cricket infrastructure built and maintained by the state associations with the help of BCCI. India has more quality players than anywhere in the world. For me, it was not a personal battle. It was a battle for the autonomy of the sports body. I respect Supreme Court as any citizen should. Supreme Court judges feel that BCCI could do better under retired judges. I wish them all the best. I'm sure Indian cricket will do well under their guidance. My commitment to the best of Indian cricket and autonomy of sports will always remain.
Verma, president of the Cricket Association of Bihar, has also spoken on these developments to NewsX's Follow Me Saha. Let's play it out.
देखिए मैं देखता हूं इस तरह से कि हम लोग हिंदुस्तान में रहते हैं और हमारे हिंदुस्तान के कानून को जिस तरह से हाल के दिनों में इन लोगों ने मजाक बना के रख दिया था, तो ये एक लेशन है उन हर स्पोर्ट्स फेडरेशन से जुड़े हुए लोगों का कि देश के सर्वोच्च न्यायालय को या कोई भी कानून का आदेश का अगर इस तरह से पालन करेगा तो उसका भी वही हाल होगा जो ठाकुर और सिरके का हुआ है। रिमूव तो किया गया ही, कंटेम्प्ट और परजरी भी इनिशिएट करने का आदेश दिया, साथ ही साथ जस्टिस लोढ़ा कमेटी के रिकमेंडेशन को एक तरह से टोटो जो 18 जुलाई को किया था सख्ती से कोर्ट ने आज उसको मान लिया। 70 साल से ऊपर, 9 साल अगर आप स्टेट क्रिकेट या बोर्ड में रह चुके हो, अगर आप करंट मिनिस्टर्स हो, अगर आप गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स हो या आप चार्ज सीटेड हो, ठाकुर जी भी चार्ज सीटेड है, ये बहुत लोगों को शायद पता हो या नहीं हो, वो भी उनका 10 और 17 दो दिन डेट है यहाँ पे इसी सुप्रीम कोर्ट में, वो भी हिमाचल लैंड स्केप में क्रिकेट मामले में चार्ज सीटेड है। तो